Hello, this is your Daily Dose of News from On Manorama. I'm your host, Deepa Soman, and these are the major news stories of the day. We begin with the update on the verdict on the defamation case in which Rahul Gandhi was sentenced to 2 years in jail. The Lok Sabha Secretariat disqualified him as MP, citing the Surat Court's conviction. Kerala Governor Arif Muhammad Khan has suffered a setback after High Court quashed the order expelling Kerala University Senate members. In a new ruling, the Supreme Court has said that mere membership of banned outfits is a UAPA offence. 14 political parties have moved the Supreme Court, seeking guidelines against arbitrary action of ED and CBI on opposition leaders. 457 arrested and 441 cops injured in protests against France's pension reforms. Let's get into the details. A day after a Surat court convicted Wayanad MP and Congress leader Rahul Gandhi in a 2019 criminal defamation case, he has been disqualified as the Member of Parliament. Announcing his disqualification, the Lok Sabha Secretariat in a notification said that it was effective from March 23rd, the day of his conviction. Consequent upon his conviction by the Court of Chief Judicial Magistrate, Surat, Rahul Gandhi, member of Lok Sabha representing the Wayanad parliamentary constituency of Kerala, stands disqualified from the membership of Lok Sabha from the date of his conviction, that is 23rd March 2023, the notification read. The court in Surat sentenced on Thursday Rahul Gandhi to 2 years in jail in a defamation case filed on a complaint by BJP MLA Purnesh Modi for his alleged remark, "How come all thieves have Modi as the common surname?" Over 30 opposition MPs, including those from the Congress, were detained on Friday as they took out a protest march from Parliament House, alleging that democracy is in danger and demanding a JPC probe into the Adani issue. Prominent leaders, including K.C. Venugopal, Adhir Chaudhary, K. Suresh, Manikam Tagore, Imran Pratap Garhi and Mohammad Javed were stopped by the police and detained at Vijay Chowk in Delhi for violating prohibitory orders, the opposition said. The Kerala High Court on Friday quashed Governor Arif Muhammad Khan's order expelling Senate members of the Kerala University. The court accepted the petitioner's contention that the governor's action was against the law. Justice Satish Nayanan passed the verdict on a petition filed by the ousted Senate members. In October 2022, Khan issued an order removing 15 Senate members of Kerala University. He also informed the 91 Senate members and the university of the decision. However, instead of implementing Khan's order, Vice Chancellor Dr. V.P. Mahadevan Pillai sought clarification about the order. But Khan responded to the letter by directing the VC to implement his order with immediate effect. The governor's action came after certain members abstained from the Kerala University Senate meeting. Out of the 13 people nominated by the governor, 2 attended the meeting. The remaining 11 members and 4 heads of departments who stayed away were dismissed. In a significant verdict, the Supreme Court on Friday overruled its 2011 judgments, which held that mere membership of a banned association is not sufficient to constitute an offence under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act 1967 or the Terrorism and Disruptive Activities Prevention Act unless it is accompanied with some overt violence. A bench of Justices M.R. Shah, C.T. Ravikumar and Sanjay Karol, while deciding a reference made by a 2-judge bench, held that mere membership of banned organization will make a person criminal and liable to be prosecuted under provisions of UAPA. The bench said the subsequent decisions passed by high courts pursuant to its 2-judge verdicts in 2011 on membership of banned outfits are bad in law and overruled. While allowing petitions of the centre and the Assam government seeking review of the apex court's 2011 verdicts on membership of banned outfits, the court said the union government was required to be heard when a provision enacted by parliament is read down. The top court said the 2011 verdicts were passed while relying on American court decisions, which cannot be done without considering the condition prevailing in India. In India, right to freedom of speech and expressions is not absolute and is subject to reasonable restriction. However, decisions of the American court can be guiding light, the bench said. Before we move on, here is a quick reminder to check out On Manorama's other podcasts, Extra Time, Wacky News and Newsbreak. Extra Time is all about what's happening in the world of football, your favorite players and more. Wacky News is a collection of the weirdest and strangest news from across the globe, and Newsbreak is a clutter-free explainer of the major news story of the week. The programs are available on all podcast platforms. Now, back to daily news stories. 14 political parties, including the Indian National Congress, Aam Aadmi Party and Shiv Sena, have moved the Supreme Court against the alleged arbitrary use of Central Investigating Agency's Enforcement Directorate and Central Bureau of Investigation in arresting opposition leaders. The matter was mentioned today before CJI D.Y. Chandrachud by Senior Advocate A.M. Singhvi. The political parties seek to lay down guidelines for law enforcement agencies and courts on arrest, remand and bail. 95% of cases are of opposition leaders. We are asking for pre-arrest guidelines and post-arrest guidelines, he submitted. The CJI has agreed to hear the matter on April 5th. A total of 457 people were arrested and 441 security forces injured on Thursday during nationwide protests against French President Emmanuel Macron's pension reform, said the country's Interior Minister Gerald Darmanin. Speaking to the media, he said that there had been 903 fires lit in the streets of Paris during by far the most violent day of protests since they began in January. French President Emmanuel Macron's government last week rammed a controversial pension reform through Parliament without a vote. The bill, among other things, raises the retirement age from 62 to 64. According to polls, two-thirds of French people oppose the pension overall. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Deepa Soman. Daily News Dose podcast is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan with technical production by Idea Brew Studios. Follow on Manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.